show the exact difference between the correlation regression as well as the regression as well as the ANOVA, because this is a basic thing. Even the people may be confusing what is exactly regression, what is ANOVA. Even some people, if you want to do apply ANOVA instead of ANOVA, we can go for regression. Like that, they're thinking it's not like this. But there is a thumb rule. Whenever you can ANOVA, we have to keep some kind of thumb rule. Yesterday, I talked about the assumptions. That assumption is satisfied only, you have to go for the ANOVA. So see the small comparisons I am quoted here. The ANOVA, the output, what is the, this for the dependent variable? The dependent variable is in continuous nature. So continuous means it may be interval or ratio. Then the independent variable should be a nominal factor. This is a basic condition to apply ANOVA. And see the, how many boxes are there. So you are seeing the three bars. What is the bar represent? It means that at least three groups category is needed. That's why they put like this. Okay, the continuous variable, they give this kind of diagram. And normally for checking the ANOVA, we are using this kind of box plot. This is called as a box plot graph for checking the ANOVA, the means relationship with the others, mean compass. We can depends on this kind of box plot. But in the case of regression, see this says, I'm talking about the simple regression. The independent variable as the dependent variable, it should both should be a continuous nature. If you are applying for the Pearson plot of Newman College, this is a basic thing. And how we are measuring, so what is the graph representation is more apt for the regression descent. It's called scatter diagram. Even yesterday I asked this question in our uses also. This called as a scatter diagram. So in this manner, it will be different. Regressions, we need two variable, independent variable, dependent variable. But in the case of the dependent variable, always only one only. You could not be go with the two dependent variable for applying regression. The main assumption to applying a regression, the dependent variable only one. The independent variable is not a third issue. You can go with one or two. If you are using only one independent variable, that is called simple linear. If you are using more, it's called a multiple. That's only the difference in the case of Pearson product normal correlation. Sorry, in the case of simple linear. Sorry. Now I'm going to talk about the difference between the correlation regression. Even yesterday, one girl is asking the question, can we do as a vice versa? For example, in the case of the correlation, we are taking independent variable, dependent variable. If you want to vice versa also, the same results may come in the case of correlation. Whether if you do the vice versa, if you alternate the independent variable to dependent, or dependent variable to independent, whether the regression lines may change, default it may be changed. That's why I'm going to tell the relationship between the regression as well as the correlation. What is the difference exactly? See, this is a property. This is a property to different with the correlation regression. In the correlation, the relationship X and Y. Okay, so see here. Suppose if you treated X is the independent variable, Y is a dependent variable. If you put it in a vice versa, also the same results may come. For example, Y is independent variable, X is a dependent variable, the same results comes. Normally, the correlation checking the relationship between the two variables, particularly talking about the direction as well as the strength. Direction represent, if the answer is comes here, plus symbol, is called positive correlation. If the symbol is comes to negative, is called a negative correlation. This we know the basic. As well as the number, the magnitude value is talking about the strengthness of the relationship. But in the case of regression, see the case of regression, I am selecting the other color, it's better, yeah. In the case of the regression, see this case, X tends to Y only. So in this case, X, that error mark, see here, it like a inverse property may satisfy. But in this case, always X is independent variable, Y is also dependent variable. If you make it some kind of interchange, automatically the scores may change. And in the case of the correlation, we are using the term movement together. So if X is increased, Y is increased, it means positive correlation. If X is increased, Y is decreased, in this case, it's called negative correlation. So it means that the movement may happen parallelly, okay? But in the case of the regression, X is a causing variable, Y is a effective variable. Okay, therefore X tends to Y. Then it's possible, the correlation, the interchange is possible. So like F of X comma Y is equal to F of Y comma X. But in the case of regression, it's not satisfying. It only one way, cannot interchange. This is the main difference between the correlation and regression. So we could not be change the x to y or y to x in the case of the regression. If you're changing default, the answer may change, the data lines may change, the line representation. Normally, in the correlation, the data represent a single point, each single point. Each single point having the meaning. Each single point having the meaning in the case of correlation. But in the regression case, we are not thinking about the data. We are thinking about only the line. See here, you are seeing the line. That is important. So this is line. Some questions also coming. Yes, what is the question, sir? Even the correlation, should variable be continuous? Exactly, for doing a correlation, the variable should be continuous for doing a correlation. Because you know the correlations, it's not for all the correlation. The correlation you know one is called Pearson product moment correlation. If you are using the Pearson product moment correlation, both the variables should be continuous nature. If you are applying the rank correlation, Spearman rank correlation, both the variables should be ordinal. Ordinal is nothing but a rank. Then if you go with biserial correlation, one variable is dichotomous, other variable is continuous. Like the lot of differences are based on the which statistic techniques is going to apply based on the scales you have. So don't think that all the correlation we are using the continuous. Only the case of the Pearson product moment correlation we are using a both the variables as a continuous. Yeah. Now this is a diagram. See this diagram. This is a correlation. I already mentioned that it is checking only the strength and weakness as well as the directions. Here each point is a meaning. Each point having the meaning. We cannot come for a single conclusion about the single dots. So we have to combine, we have to see all the data only, then only we can come for conclusion whether it's a positive or a negative or a perfect positive or not. But in the case of regressions, we are talking about the line only. See, there is a line input center. This is a line only we are talking. The regression is nothing but the state and equation only we are telling. We are predicting the y value from the value of x. That is called regression. So just I'm going to be highlight the types of regression, linear regression, logist regression, polynomial regression, step-by regression. Yesterday Sars is talking about this, why I'm skipping. Rigid regressions, natural regressions, then elastic net regression. This much of regression types are there. This I thought is very much important for you. And if you need, you can take a screenshot. Even I'm sharing these things to Google Classroom also. Even the regression, lot of types are there. Yesterday also some people asking the logist regressions. So in the case of logist regressions, your dependent variable should be dichotomous. See the case, what is the things you have found from there in the sense? The dependent variable of the regression, the dependent variable of the all the types of regressions, it only one only. But in the case of the independent variable, it may be differ. It may be differ. So if you are using only one, that is called simple linear, but the independent variables interval ratio, dependent variable interval ratio. In the case of multiple regressions, it may be interval ratio or dichotomous, even we can use for the some kind of categorical variable also, but the dependent variable should be a continuous. In the case of logist regression, the independent variable interval ratio or a dichotomous, but in the case of the dependent variable dichotomous, only the two classification, true or false, yes or no, that kind of things. Then in the case of ordinary regressions, 1 plus nominal plus are dichotomous, then dependent variable should be ordinal. So this is a chart I'm already sharing with you, kindly go through it. Yes, just I'm moving this one. And one more question is we asked by the Manish, I think so. So see here, he's asking what is the constant value is representing. That's why I'm going to focus this one. And this is just a linear regression. This is our equation. See this equation. From this equation, in the questions you asked yesterday, what is called that constant value. So that constant value, normally we are using the term as a beta naught. Beta naught is called as intercept. Mathematically, we are talking about as intercept. Intercept. What is intercept? So in the diagram, I am focusing. Parallelly, the one more error may come. So that is error. We may use the term as a residual error or random error. We are using the different terms. This line, it will be showing the exact meaning of the what is the beta zero. MX plus B, you are using as a term. Some people are using AX plus B or some people are using MX plus B. But the logic same only. In this case, Y is a dependent variable. X is an independent variable. This is called error. What is error? First, we have to know what is error. This is called residual error. See this case. I have how many dates? So did you found how many data I'm having? So how many data am I having? Anyone can tell how many data is spreaded there? How many data are there?
One independent variable.
No, no, I'm not talking about the independent
variable. Six
data, yeah, six data. So that data, yeah, exactly. So let's see echo, please, I request all to know. I think you connected the two devices, that's why it's happened. Yeah, see here, this is one point, the second point, third point, fourth point, fifth point, sixth point. Therefore, I'm having the only five data. Okay, so five data. So combined together, it's called five. So now, but we are going to check only the straight line equation only. So we are going to check this straight line only. But what is the problem? The straight line slice here, but the dot, our original data slice in different points. So the differences between the original point slice as well as our straight line, that is called as, yeah? See here, this is a difference. This is called random error. For here, this is an error. So here, not that much of error. Here, there is a error. Here, there is a error. Here, there is a error. That is called as a residual error or random error, we are telling. But in the case of beta naught, what is the beta naught? See this straight line. Particularly in the y-axis, it's not start from the zero frame. It start from here only. So it means that this spot is totally, what is that? Here, no one can get the mark in this area. So your the point, this point is called as a constant. So in this area, your minimum mark, it start from here only. The y start from here. For example, I'm conducting some kind of intelligent test in my classroom. Normally, in our classroom, the people are sitting, they have the intellectual because they are reaching the MET level. So we could not go for the intelligence of them as a zero, because none of the people for intelligence not zero. It means, so they are the average. Therefore, our prediction is that, so they, all the scores may go with more than 70. So I'm talking about average intelligence. So the intelligence is above 70 only. Therefore, the constant value is 70. Then after this only, we are giving some kind of measurement. Then we are checking the other extra intelligence what we have. Therefore, this part is called intelligence. So here, nothing, the no score is to be lies in this part. So normally in the mathematically, we use the term as intercept. Then the beta one is representing the slope of the straight line. Slope of the straight line. So this is why we are using as here, this kind of things, okay? Yeah, so example, the Pooja is giving some kind of example, exactly same. So now I'm skipping this one, and some other people's not submitted your assignment, particularly the regression. That's why I'm starting within a 5 to 10 minutes, I'm talking about how to do a regression analysis with the use of Excel. Then after that, I'm moving to my factor analysis. I request you all to open the data sets which I'm sharing in the morning, the Excel sheet. Please, I request all to open the Excel sheet, and I'm really happy. Some of the students, some of the participants, they already shared the report of the regression analysis through Excel. That's good, good sign. I'm so happy. Even I'm not talking that they are explored. So I could understand they are explored from the end. Due to that only, they are able to make that kind of things. So I request you all open the Excel sheets which I'm sharing to you. So those who are open it, kindly type in the chat box. So open the Excel sheet which I'm sharing to you, kindly type in the chat box. So can I go further? Now I'm going to teach how to do a correlation. First I'm going to talk about the correlation. Then after that I'm moving to the regression analysis through Excel. So little faster I'm going. The first sheets, kindly open the sheet one, SL1. Kindly open the sheet one. SL1 represent the sheet one. There is a two variable, achievement and study habits. Can you tell which is an independent variable, which is a dependent variable? Can you type in?
Sir, which Excel file is
dependent, sir? And the study habits is independent.
Madam, the morning, you got the mail, you received mail from my end, the morning.
Yes, there are some four files that I see.
Actually, the four files, no? There is a five files.
Regression set.
Yeah. So in the that's regression data set. The other files is what is that?
Okay. Thank you, sir. Sorry.
Other files are SPSS files. Okay. Only one Excel file I showed you. Yes. See here, there is an achievement and study habits. So the study habits is independent variable. Achievement is a dependent variable. Yes. Exactly. Is correct. Now I move to the data. Please kindly see the path data and data analysis. So here I'm going to apply the correlations. Whether the correlation is there, kindly see. Correlation is there here. So click the correlation and click OK. Then what is our input range? What is our input range? Any idea? Which things I have to keep it as input range? I may keep it the both independent variable, dependent variable together as a input range. And I'm clicking the label in the first row. Why I'm clicking the label in the first row?
Because we are choosing both the cells containing achievement and study habits in this input range.
Exactly. Then finally, I'm clicking the output range. Output range, keep the cursor, kindly ensure, because the people having the doubt after clicking that, they are keeping the cursor, but it's not working. It won't be work. See here, what is the problem I did here in the sense, after clicking the output range, you have to keep the cursor in the empty box. Then after that, you can select any empty rows. Then click OK. Now we are getting the achievement and study habits relationship. What is the relationship? So it is whether it's a positive relationship or negative relationship.
Positive,
right?
There is a strong relationship.
Yeah, strong relationship. So this becomes more than 0.85. So this is the way we can do it. So just I'm skipping because these things, you know, just I'm moving to the regression now. So I request all to delete this column. Yeah, delete this. Then I move to the regression. Yes. Now we have to tell we have the two variables, study habits and achievements. I'm giving some kind of idea. So simple linear regressions, the criterion variable. What is the criterion variable represent? Any idea? What is the criterion variable? Means what?
Dependent variable.
It is called output variable. It's nothing but our dependent variable. Predictor, in the normally we may use the term as a predictor while doing the regression analysis. What is this? That is called independent variable. So in this case, how many independent? One independent, one dependent. Therefore, is it called what? Is it called what? Whether it's a multiple regression
linear.
Or I'm going to do a simple linear. Okay, ready. So for that, where we can go data analysis. So kindly check whether the regression is here. So where is the regression? Yeah, the regression is here. Click OK. Now we have to give the answer. This I already selected. That's why you're seeing this one. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Now see, what is my input range? Any idea? What is my input range? Kindly see, there is a two range: input wide range, input X range.
What is the difference range, between the achievement, range? Achievement,
wide range, achievement.
Yeah, exactly. So don't put it reversely. So if you put it reversely, the answer may change. So our case, what is our dependent variable? Achievement. Therefore, I am keeping the achievement there. So kindly check the achievement is comes in B1 to B31. What is our independent variable? Our independent variable is
study habits.
So I am selecting the study habits. So after selecting the study habits, I am keeping this one. I am clicking the labels also. That's, you know, because I am selecting the heading also. Then click confident interval, because we are going to check with 95% of level of confidence only. Then select the output range and keep the cursor there and select one empty region. So I'm going to be generate the answer in N24. Then residues, calling the residues. If you need, you can go with residuals and standard residuals. Then these are things you can select. So normally residues is enough, only for standard residuals and residual plots. Only the normal probability curve, otherwise you can go with residual plots also. So you may get good. Residual plots are blind fit plots also. Then click OK. Once you click OK, now you are getting the results. Kindly see the results. The same results you may found out from the SPSS also. So because those are not having the SPSS, don't worry, you can use the Excel itself. How many of them got the result? How many of them got the same results?
Got some.
Yes, so multiple R, then R square, then adjusted R square, standard square, then regression. So here it comes, you can extend like this. So what it means, it comes here minus 0.009. Okay, what it means? So because it goes more than 0.0000 like this. So it's significantly a lot. So don't think that it's not 1.63. So after this, you are getting the E minus 0.09 represent. Before that, there is a zeros may happen. 9-digit zeros may is there. Okay, so this is, you are getting this answer. Then in the side also, in the down, you are getting residual output, then probability output. These are things not much needed. Then you are scattering parallel to the diagram. See here, this for the normal property plot. One is a normal property curve. This is whether it's a positive correlation, negative correlation. Kindly tell anyone, is it a positive correlation and a negative correlation?
Positive.
How you can tell it's a positive
correlation?
From which
positive correlation.
Of the line.
So there's a three diagrams are there. Which diagram we can check for the what is that?
Line fit chart, sir.
There is a this is called what is the predicted achievement? Any idea what is represent predicted achievement? What is the predicted achievement?
The slope.
Yeah, that is the line. So that is the line only we are founding. We are founding the straight line equation. No, that is the line is called predicted achievement. Now I request you all to go with the there is a sheet I'm given to you. The result RESSL1. Click this one. RESSL1. The same result I'm giving a CA interpretation also. This is very good for you. Even the people having condition, how to write the interpretations. You can write the interpretations based on this findings. Okay. See
so
here.
Where is it?
You can go with the seat. There is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 seat. RES/SL/1. You got?
Yes, so I got it. Thank you.
In the Excel itself, I'm giving you a result of separately. So even the people having doubts how we can write the interpretation, that's why I'm giving it specific. So here, this is a result. The same result only I'm copying and pasting here. The parallel I'm giving the report also. So we have to take it this one in the R square value. Therefore, R square value is 0.7327. What it means is that the predicted study habits goes account for 72.27% of the variance of achievement scores. And now today I share the Excel sheet. Please kindly check your mail. In the mail, I'm sharing the 5 attachments. Out of 5 attachments, only one Excel file. Only one Excel file. Kindly see that attachment file. Okay, so other things is SPSS file. Now, the regression table is talking about 0.00. So because I'm extending the, see here, the same score, see here, the same score only, but I am converting into a decimal, it's come as a 0.00, that's why it comes like this. Then, this is where we have to write the interpretations. You have to write, this is called APA format. How we can write the APA format in the sense F of 1, 28. What is 1 and 28 represent? Any idea? 1 is the degrees of freedom between group. 28 is the degrees of freedom between group. It's called residual. Then 76.76 F value. Then P less than 0.07. Then R square value. These are the things you can quote. You should be quote while writing the interpretations of your result. And parallel you can.
Sir, yes. Is little slow.
Okay, these things you attended yesterday, no? This way because okay anyway I'm going slowly. This is a way here to write the interpretation in a dissertation or a thesis. So here in the ANOVA table, the F is a F value. 1 is degrees of freedom of the regression, that is called between group. The 28, the degrees of freedom of the within group. Then the 76.76, this is an answer for the F value. Then P is less than 0.01, so this is an P value. Then we have to put it comma, then finally you can write the value of R square. What is the R square value? 0.73. So we already mentioned that the R square value is called 72. So please, I request all the team that it is 73. Instead of 73, I'm typing 72. 73.27% variance in the achievement score. This is the exact result. It means that your independent variable make an influences 73.27% of the influences. It make because of the reason only the achievement scores having some variance happens. So that is the things it is focusing. And there is a last table. This is called our T table. In this table, we have to write this interpretation. How we can write the study habits is significant predictors of achievement score. How we are writing this one? Based on the P value. Based on the P value. Then beta, that beta values, these know the coefficient value. Okay. So that is called 15 point. So there is a mistake, 0.52. So you can change like this, 15.2. I type as wrongly. So we can see the results. What is the results of the first? Yeah, 15.2. So I what is my mistakes? Okay. No. Where is this? Yes. Yes. So sorry. This is a beta is representing the magnitude value. So beta not only the what is the constant value. The beta one is 0.52. The beta one is nothing but the coefficient of x. The coefficient of x. Therefore, I'm writing is a beta value 0.52. Then t value t 28. The 28 represented degrees of freedom. 28 is a degrees of freedom. Then you know the formula for degrees of freedom of the t. So n1 plus n2 minus 2. In this formula, if you apply, you may get it. Then the value, then p value. Then finally, you can write the r square value. In down, you can attach this also, stray habits fit line. So these all things is needed while writing the interpretations in the dissertation purpose. I move to the second one. The second one also is a linear relationship only, simple linear. That's why I'm going to third example. Third also is a linear. I'm going to the fourth example. See, there is a four, ML1. So I request you all to pick the ML1. What is the ML1? This is nothing but the multiple linear. Kindly see what is my independent variable, what is my dependent variable in this case. So you are getting you are seeing the four variables: achievement, study habits, attitude, and stress.
So achievement is dependent variable, other three will be the independent variable.
That's why I put like this. The criterion variable only one. Then predictors, there is a, we have the attitude, study habits, motivation. So motivation is not there, so I am removing this one. Okay, only the three. So previously motivation I could either remove that. So therefore the study habits, attitude and stress, we have the three. Now I'm going to do the calculation. So you can direct me how we can do, where we can do data analysis, then regression. Then now you have to tell. So which are things I have to select? What is my input Y range? What is my input Y range? Kindly give the answer.
B1 to B31.
Oh yeah, so exactly. So our input range of Y is nothing but a dependent variable. Our achievement is a dependent variable. So I'm selecting this one. Okay. What is my input variable? So that is my nothing but the our independent variable. What is my independent
T2
variable?
C22E31.
Yes. Sorry.
We have to take C, D, E. All the three.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. So don't select only the C only. So we have to select three. See here, I'm selecting the study habits, attitude, and stress together and extending up to the end score. Okay, so it's selecting the C1 to E31. So you have to select the all the three columns of your independent variable. Then I'm clicking the labels, I'm clicking the confidence level, then I'm clicking the output range, I'm clicking the output range. So I need only this much residuals, residual plots, line fit plots, and normality probability plots. So I don't need the residuals in the sense I remove the residuals also. I don't need the normal property plot also, that's I'm moving. So only I think only two things, residual plots and line fit. Even the residual plots is not needed, only the line fit is enough for us. So I can go with only the line fit, then click OK. So now we are getting the output. Did you get the output? So how many of them get the same output?
Yes.
You got the yes, same sir. Output? Yeah, so whether yes. The ANOVA table, the model is significant or not? Can you tell the model is significant or not? Okay.
Less than 0.05. It's exponentially
yeah.
much
yeah, okay. more. So one thing you'll do, so the people, you are not getting the score like this in the sense, what like this we are getting the sense. You have to open your home page.
So input range is showing non-numeric data, like that message is coming, sir.
Input, I think you're selecting two or three, that is why. Otherwise, there is a mistake while selecting, you did some mistakes. 1 minute, I will do one thing. Kindly see my display, then based on this, you can do it. 1 minute, kindly see one second. I'm deleting this result.
Yes, sir.
Okay, see, so kindly see. Delete. Okay. Now the empty space I reserved. Okay, see here, I'm opening the data, then data analysis, regression, click OK, right? Then in this first, you have to select the input Y range. in the input Y range, keep the cursor in the input Y range. Then after this, you can select the achievement. So you select the achievement. So then B1 to B31, kindly ensure whether you are selecting the proper one, proper input of the Y. Then I'm going with the input X. What is my input X? All my independent variables, steady habits, attitude, stress. I'm selecting all the three. I'm tracking up to the end. So finish it. So if you are keeping some empty space, you don't be read, kindly select only the numbers which you type in the boxes. Okay. Then select the labels, confidence level, the output range. I'm going to change the output range here. Then I'm going to keep only the line to fit. Click OK. Now you are over it. So because I'm there is, yeah, now it's coming. Yes. See here.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. So now you are getting this one. See this case. In this case, some people are having the doubt. There is here because the cells is having the E12. What it means? Because we can convert this as a number, then automatically the problem will resolve. How we can convert as a number? Go with the home page. In the home page, so you click this options. You can select as a, normally select as a general. You can select as a number. So if you select the number, you can go with number decimals. I can go with 5 decimals. Click OK. Then automatically you are getting this one. So you are getting the significant level. Normally, what this means? This one represent before the 3.60. No, before that there is a 12-digit 00, 0.00000, 12 times. Then after the 36051. So that is the short form of the things they are given. They're like exponential series they make it. But for confirming, to convert this number into a normal number pattern, you can go with home page and go with the number. In the number, you can select the number pattern and select the decimal which decimal you want. So I hope Shweta Singh, you understand, no? That is for the number, because normally the Excel is selecting the taking the other format. So we have to convert it to a number format and the problem is solved. Now this is the output. I got this output. Do you know how to write the interpretation? Kindly go with this. There is a RESML1. Please, I request you all to go with the result page. Go with the result page. I'm giving the result page in down sheet. If you go with the result page, you can see the same report. I'm giving the report like this. R square value 0.8815. Take this at the predictor, steady habits, attitude and stress account for 88.1% of variances in the achievement score. It means that our independent variable causing making some nearly 88.1% of influences variances happen because of the our independent variable to the dependent variable of achievement. Then the overall regression, see whether the regression table, the model is to be fit or not. The model is fit or not. Can you tell the model is fit or not?
It's fit, sir. It is fit, sir.
Yeah, then we can see the down table. Okay, now the down table, what you're seeing? You are seeing the coefficient. What is our beta zero? Our constant value is 53.64. It means that the scores of Y, it may go after 53 only. It not comes below the 53. You got clear what is the meaning of this intercept? It means that your minimum score, the minimum score of the achievement of your class, it start from
53 point.
That is the intercept, because no one can down, no one have the what is the lowest mark less than the 53. That is why it's come as an intercept. Now this is a why you have to write the interpretations. Steady habits, the beta 1, 0 point. This is called the coefficient of X. I'm writing like this. See here. So now the beta 2 value, then beta 3 value. Anyone can tell the equation of this regression equation? Anyone can tell the regression equation? Anyone can hide
equation the equation? Equation equal to 53.6427 plus 0.3375 brackets study plus 0.2838 bracket attitude plus, sorry, minus 0.5252 stress.
Yeah. Suppose you are getting the minus value, see here, don't be changes positive. It's like a minus. The stress is making a negative correlations to the achievement. Normally, stress is a negative, you know. If you look onto the stress as well as the achievement, That is a relationship is a negative relationship. That's why the answer is comes negative. But the case of steady habits and achievement is a positive relationship. That is why the positive signs comes. In the case of attitude as well as the achievement is a positive relationship. That's a positive signs may comes. But in the case of stress, why it comes a negative in the sense? Because if the stress is increased, achievement decrease. If the stress is decreased, the achievement may increase. That's why it's called negative correlation. Due to that only it comes like this. Okay. Okay, I hope now we understand these things. Can I move to the factor analysis? Do you have any doubts in the Excel calculation? Because some people not finished your task yesterday. That's why I'm focusing this one. So those who are not having the SPSS, you can do the regression analysis by use of Excel itself. Okay.